This video will talk about the ways we name teeth and our two dentitions. Each set of teeth is referred to as a dentition. Humans have two dentitions, two sets of teeth. What's commonly known as the baby teeth are known as the deciduous dentition or the primary dentition. The adult teeth are the permanent teeth, the permanent dentition, or the secondary dentition. Humans have 20 deciduous teeth and 32 permanent teeth. We only have two dentitions, but there's also a stage of life called the mixed dentition. That is when there are both primary teeth and permanent teeth in the patient's mouth. Another stage of growth is when the child is edentulous. That's up to age 6 months. The primary dentition typically is age 6 months to 6 years. Permanent dentition begins at 12 years after the mixed dentition is complete. In these pictures, you see mixed dentition. There are two central incisors on the maxillary arch, and you can barely see the incisal edges of the four mandibular incisors. I know these are permanent teeth because of the mammillons, the curved or scalloped edge. These are three mammillons. The teeth that replace primary teeth, such as these incisors, have another name. These are called succedaneous teeth. They succeed, they follow the primary tooth. So number 8 and 9 are both succedaneous teeth, as they replace numbers E and F when E and F are exfoliated. Teeth that are not succedaneous in the permanent dentition are the permanent molars. The permanent molars are not succedaneous, as they do not replace any primary teeth. Remember, there are fewer primary teeth than permanent teeth. We have two arches, the maxillary arch and the mandibular arch. When we divide the mouth into four quadrants, we refer to them as quadrants. Dividing into fourths involves the maxillary arch and mandibular arch, and then we divide those in half at the midline between 8 and 9 and 24 and 25. Now we have four parts: upper right, upper left, and lower right. When we name teeth, we typically begin in the upper right. We have six sextants. We can divide the mouth into six portions: upper right posterior, maxillary anterior, upper left posterior, and then the lower left, mandibular anterior, and lower right posterior sextants. So those lines would be drawn between the canines and the premolars. For sextants, you would divide anterior teeth from posterior teeth between the canine and the first premolar. Each quadrant has the same number of incisors, the same number of canines, same number of premolars, and the same number of molars. This is not true for all species, but for humans, each quadrant will have the same number of each classification of tooth. Again, we separate the anterior sextant from the posterior sextants between the first premolar and the canines, like between number 5 and 6, or on the lower between 27 and 28, and that's just the right side. The left side you can see with the orange oval and green oval to help determine anterior sextant from posterior sextant. We have four ways to name teeth. We can use a word name, naming the quadrant and the tooth type, such as upper left, first molar, or perhaps lower left, central incisor, or upper right, second premolar. Or in the deciduous teeth, the upper right deciduous first molar. The other three ways to name have each is a system. The other three are systems. The other three, one is the universal system, one is the Palmer notation system, sometimes just referred to as Palmer or Palmer notation, and then there's the international system, also known as the World Dental Federation, or FDI. FDI, remember that with the word federation, but the international system, universal system, and Palmer notation. The first numbering system we'll talk about is called the universal system, and it is the most common system of numbering teeth here in the U.S. We start upper right and work our way to upper left, then move to lower left and lower right. There are 32 teeth, so they're numbered 1 through 32. For the deciduous teeth, it's capital A through capital T. Again, we begin on the upper right. The third molar is tooth number 1. And we work our way around to the upper left third molar. Then we drop down to the mandibular arch and work our way back around to lower right. The sequence for the deciduous dentition is the same. We begin with a capital A on the upper right, most posterior tooth, which is the deciduous second molar. And work our way around to upper left, then drop down to K, the lower left second deciduous molar, and work our way to the lower right, capital T, or tooth number T. The Palmer notation system uses an L shape or a right angle shape or piece of a square, and that L will be facing whichever direction will best designate the quadrant. If typed on a keyboard, it may look like L3, but with digital abilities, usually you will see it looking like this piece of a square or a right angle shape. The second portion of the notation is the number of the tooth when counting from the midline. We count from the midline back to the third molar. We look at our four quadrants, and that's the first portion of the notation. And then the second portion would be the number. Starting with the central incisors, we number the teeth 1 through 8. So in each quadrant, there are 8 teeth. The highest number in the Palmer system would be 8. orthodontists tend to use the Palmer system more so than using the universal system. This slide shows some examples of how we would number or how we would notate tooth number 8 using the Palmer system, how we would notate tooth number 9, tooth number 28, tooth number 22 using the Palmer notation. The deciduous dentition in the Palmer notation system is very similar to the permanent dentition. However, again, we will use capital letters A through E to designate which tooth we're talking about. So in Palmer, you designate the quadrant by the shape of the L or the direction the L is facing, and we designate the tooth by A through E. The third way to name teeth is the FDI system or the International Federation system. This system is used by the rest of the world. The U.S. uses the universal system and other countries use the international system. The international system uses the quadrant and then names the tooth 1 through 8. But before we name the tooth, we name the quadrant. So each tooth is going to have two numbers. The first number is the quadrant number. The second number is the tooth number when counted from the midline. The first number is the name of the quadrant. The permanent dentition can be quadrant 1, 2, 3, or 4. The deciduous dentition would be quadrants 5, 6, 7, and 8. Again, we are counting from upper right to upper left to lower right. So the first number in the name using the FDI system, the first number is the quadrant name. So an upper right central incisor would be tooth number 1-1. I've heard it both ways where you say tooth number 11 or you say tooth number 1-1. Or tooth number 25 is an upper left premolar, the fifth from the arch in quadrant 2. Again, I've heard people use the number 25. I've also heard that you say the number 25. So either way can be considered correct. Textbooks tend to say use the number 25 instead of saying 25. But people that use the system tend to say 25 or 26. Here's a diagram showing all 32 teeth with their numbers when we're using the FDI system. Likewise, the deciduous dentition and the FDI numbers to denote each deciduous tooth. And here's a table that will show you each tooth and its number in the FDI International system. It's a two-digit notation. But don't get confused with tooth number 14 in the universal system is a totally different tooth from tooth number 14 in the FDI system. And in this course, if I say 14, I'm using the universal system unless I tell you otherwise. So unless stated otherwise on a test, quiz, or lecture, we're using the universal system of numbering. So, think universal unless we say otherwise, for the type of numbering system.